الرحيم. الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستهديه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلله فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له. أشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. رضيت بالله ربا وبالإسلام دينا وبمحمد النبي ورسولا. أما بعد، قال الله تبارك وتعالى: أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم، فقلت استغفروا ربكم إنه كان غفارا، يرسل السماء عليكم مدرارا ويمددكم بأموال وبنين ويجعل لكم جنات ويجعل لكم أنهارا. الآية. My dear brothers and sisters in Islam, السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. So then the great name of Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala, that we are in the house of Allah in reminding each other about the Quran and Sunnah of Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. First of all, I give congratulations to those brothers and sisters who have been to Hajj Baytullah al-Haram. I ask Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala to make their Hajj Hajjum Mabrur inshaAllah, Sa'yum Mashkur, وَذَمَّ مَقْفُورِ إِنْ شَاءَ اللَّهُ تَبَارَكَ وَتَعَالَى. And just reminding them as well, you went there, that was a mercy of Allah تَبَارَكَ وَتَعَالَى upon you. And do remember that Allah تَبَارَكَ وَتَعَالَى chosen you for this year that you go and visit His house. And I am giving advice to those brothers and sisters who haven't been there: get ready, get yourself ready for that lifetime trip, which is once a lifetime, and prepare yourself. You will enjoy yourself there. You will enjoy ibadah, worship down there. And you will see the historical place down there, insha'Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. One of the ulama says that I saw one person which reached to Baytullah al-Haram, and he couldn't walk. He had a problem in his legs, couldn't walk properly. That is a long time ago. I told that person, why you came to Baytullah al-Haram here? Even though this is not compulsory upon you, you have sickness, you have udhr, you have excuse. He told, I came here because of love which I had for this place, for the house of Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala. In the long journey, which was months and months, the love of mine with this place, the holy place, made it really short for me. Made it really short for me. Subhanallah. Our Shaykh Kababa, he told us a story while we were in Hajj there. The brothers in Senegal, what they're doing, they have love to go to Hajj. What they are doing, how they prepare themselves. They are growing animals. Goats, sheep, they're growing it up, and afterwards they're selling it. Whatever they got from that, they are keeping it one side. That might take them 8 till 10 years to collect the money. Then afterwards, they are going to the house of Allah Tabaraka. One elderly person, he had these animals for that intention, with that intention, and one person came and stolen that animal from him. Then he was crying and crying and crying. Then people came to him, told him, why you are crying so much? He told, I crying because I was keeping that animal to sell it and get the money to go to house of Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala. Now he steal my animal, I will be delayed to get to the house of Allah. Therefore, my dear brother in Islam, you make azm, azm as well in your heart. You have to have a love of those places in your heart. Then Allah Ta'ala going to take you there. Some of the brothers says, Allah Ta'ala didn't write to me to go there. When he write to me, he decide to wants for me to go there, then I will go. No. Allah Ta'ala is Razik as well. Allah Ta'ala giving you food as well. If you sit in your home, will Allah Ta'ala feed you? No. You have to go. You work every day. You do something. The same thing, Hajj is Ibadah. If you want to go there, you have to prepare yourself. You have to have love of that holiest place in your heart. You have to earn some money, put it aside to go to Baytullah al-Haram. May Allah Ta'ala make us from those who goes to the house of Allah Ta'ala, Baytullah, every year, inshaAllah Ta'ala. Today's topic is about the virtues of istighfar, virtues of asking forgiveness from Allah Ta'ala. Brothers and sisters, of course, we are not free of sin. We are not free of sin. Every day, every month, every year, we are making sin. But of course, we have a very merciful Creator, Allah Ta'ala. We have a very merciful Prophet, Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. He showed us the ways. How will Allah Ta'ala forgive us those sins? This is the beauty of this Islam. Beauty of Islam. Istighfar is not only for us as a nation of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. That started from the first human, from Adam alayhi salatu wa salam. And whoever comes till the day of judgment, they will ask forgiveness from Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. Adam and Hawa, they forgotten and they have done mistakes. And they ask Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala, Rabbana zalamna anfusana, wa illam taghfir lana wa tarhamna, lanakunanna min al-khasirin. Oh, our Lord, we made a mistake. We harmed ourselves. If you not become merciful upon us, if you do not forgive us, we will be from those who are destroyed. Then Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala forgive them. Allah Ta'ala accept their tawbah. فَتَلَقَّى آدَمُ مِنْ رَبِّهِ كَلِمَاتٍ فَتَابَ عَلَيْهِ إِنَّهُ هُوَ التَّوَّابُ الرَّحِيمُ. Also, Nuh alayhi salatu wasalam, he was saying, رَبِّ اغْفِرْ لِي وَلِوَالِدَيَّ وَلِمَنْ دَخَلَ بَيْتِيَ مُؤْمِنًا. His dua was that, O Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala, forgive me and forgive my parents and whoever enters to my house with the belief, with the iman. This was the dua of Nuh alayhi salatu wa salam. And also Musa alayhi salatu wa salam as well, رَبِّ إِنِّي ظَلَمْتُ نَفْسِي فَاغْفِرْ لِي. When he killed a person by mistake, he punched him and he died. By mistake. Then afterwards, he going back to who? To his Lord. Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala. Oh Allah Ta'ala, forgive me. I harmed myself. I made a zulm. I killed a person mistakenly. Also, Sulaiman alayhi salatu wasalam, Rabbi ighfir li wa hab li mulka la yanbaghi li ahadin min ba'di. Oh Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala, forgive me and give a kingdom which you know will not give it to anyone after me. That is Sulaiman alayhi salatu wa salam. Subhanallah, you know the stories of Sulaiman alayhi salam. Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, wastaghfir li dhanbik wa lil mu'minina wal mu'minat. Allah Ta'ala ordering him to who? To Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. For ask Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala forgiveness for you and believe mu'min in mu'minat. This is Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And also, order for us from Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala, فَاسْتَقِيمُوا إِلَيْهِ وَاسْتَغْفِرُوهُ. Be perfect on the path of Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala, وَاسْتَغْفِرُوهُ. This is the order from Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala to us. Ask Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala forgiveness, that Allah ta'ala gonna forgive you. Subhanallah. There are a lot of hadith of Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He says, Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, oh people, ask forgiveness from Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala and make repentance to Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. I am making repentance to Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala every day. How many times? 70 times. Subhanallah. In another ayah, another hadith, Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, I make repentance to Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala 100 times every day. Subhanallah. Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, who was free of sin, even though he makes 100 times istighfar. How about us sinful slaves of Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala? We have to make it more and more and more. Also, Hadith al-Qudsi, Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala says, Ya ibadi, innakum tukhti'una bil-layli wal-nahar, wa ana aghfiru al-dhunuba jami'a, fastaghfiruni aghfiru lakum. Oh my slave, you make mistakes day and night, but I'm the one who forgive. Ask me forgiveness, I will forgive you. Subhanallah. And there are other ahadith of Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, من أحب أن تسره صحيفته فليكثر فيها من الاستغفار. The person who will be happy with his book of deed in day of judgment, the one who makes a lot of istighfar, he asked Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala a lot in this dunya, he will be so successful in hereafter. And also, Abi Huraira radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he says, I heard from Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he was saying, Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala will be happy from his slave, from a slave who make a sin, and he came back to Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. He asked Allah ta'ala, oh Allah ta'ala, I made a sin, but you are the forgiver, forgive me. Then Allah ta'ala, he will say, this is my slave, he made a sin. He made a sin, and he knows there is forgiver. That is me that Allah Ta'ala said, I forgive it to him. He will make sin twice. The third time, Allah Ta'ala will say, I forgive it to you. I forgive it to you. Subhanallah. Another hadith, طُوبَ لِمَنْ وَجَدَ فِي صَحِيفَتِهِ إِسْتِغْفَارًا كَثِيرًا. Glad tiding for the person who will find out a lot of istighfar. His book of deeds is mostly full of istighfar in day of judgment. He will be successful. In another hadith, Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he says, Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala comes to the first guy every midnight, and he asks, مَنْ يَسْتَغْفِرُنِي فَأَغْفِرُ لَهُ. Is there any person who asks me forgiveness, I will forgive to that person. My dear brothers and sisters in Islam, there are a lot of virtues of the istighfar. Of course, in day of judgment, there is a lot of rewards for you. In this dunya, there are rewards as well. You will get benefit of istighfar in this dunya. The first one is Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala will forgive you your sin. وَمَنْ يَعْمَلْ سُوءًا أَوْ يَظْلِمْ نَفْسَهُ ثُمَّ يَسْتَغْفِرِ اللَّهِ يَجِدِ اللَّهَ غَفُورًا رَحِيمًا. A person who makes a sin, then afterwards he asks Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala forgiveness, he will find Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala so merciful and so forgiver. He will forgive that person. Secondly, if you're facing any punishment of Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala, for example, this year Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala wrote to you that you will face any problems, and you carry on making istighfar, Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala take that punishment, that problem away from you because of istighfar. Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala says, وَمَا كَانَ اللَّهُ مُعَذِّبَهُمْ وَأَنْتَ فِيهِمْ وَمَا كَانَ اللَّهُ مُعَذِّبُهُمْ وَهُمْ يَسْتَغْفِرُونَ. Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala will never forgive them. Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala will never punish them as long you are among them, Ya Rasulullah. And as long they are saying istighfar, asking forgiveness from Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. If you ask Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala forgiveness, do you remember? The qadr of Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala gonna change. The problem you face, Allah Ta'ala will turn it away from you, inshaAllah tabarak wa ta'ala. And also, if you have some kind of sadness, and also you are poor, then what are you going to do? Ask Allah tabarak wa ta'ala. Ask for forgiveness from Allah tabarak wa ta'ala. Abdullah ibn Abbas radiallahu ta'ala, he said that the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioned, مَنْ لَزِمَ الْإِسْتِغْفَارَ جَعَلَ اللَّهُ لَهُ مِنْ كُلِّ ضِيقٍ مَخْرَجًا وَمِنْ كُلِّ هَمٍ فَرَجًا وَرَزَقَهُ مِنْ حَيْثُ لَا يَحْتَسِبْ. Subhanallah. A person who says continuously istighfar, asking istighfar from Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, if he has any kind of sadness, Allah tabarak wa ta'ala will take it away from him. If he has any kind of problems, Allah Ta'ala will free him from those problems. And Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala give him food or wealth from the way he will not imagine even. From where this wealth came to me. And also, if you want Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala to bring the rain down, no water, istighfar. The second thing, you ask Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala to make you wealthy. You ask Allah Tabarak, you don't have children. Ask Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala to give you some children. What you have to do? You have to ask Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala forgiveness. Listen to this beautiful ayah. This ayah is about the Nuh alayhi salatu wasalam. فَقُلْتُ اسْتَغْفِرُوا رَبَّكُمْ إِنَّهُ كَانَ غَفَّارًا يُرْسِلِ السَّمَاءَ عَلَيْكُمْ مِدْرَارًا وَيُمْدِدْكُمْ بِأَمْوَالٍ وَبَنِينَ وَيَجْعَلْ لَكُمْ جَنَّاتٍ وَيَجْعَلْ لَكُمْ أَنْهَارًا. Subhanallah. This is the promise of who? Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala. Nuh alayhi salatu salam said, I told to my people, Istaghfiru Rabbakum. Ask forgiveness from your Lord, from Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala. إِنَّهُ كَانَ غَفَّارًا. Because He is the only one who can forgive you. He is forgiver. Second thing, يرسل السماء عليكم مدرارا. If you have a problem of or rain, no rain coming down. You are thirsty, no water with you. What you do? Ask Allah تبارك وتعالى forgiveness, الاستغفار. اللهم اغفر لي, اللهم اغفر لي, اللهم اغفر لي. Do remember, Allah تبارك وتعالى bring the rain down. That's why. The time of Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu, people came to Umar radiallahu anhu, Ya Amir al-Mu'mineen, there is no rain since months and months. You ask Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala to bring the rain down. Then Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he stood in asking, Astaghfirullah, Astaghfirullah, Astaghfirullah. Nothing else till Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala bring the rain down. Also, Hassan al-Basri, rahimahullah, one person came to him and told him, Ya Hassan al-Basri, I'm a poor person. Show me some way that Allah Ta'ala make me rich. He told him, say astaghfirullah. Another person came and he told him, I don't have children. Ask it, show me something. I will do it that Allah Ta'ala gonna give me children. He told him, say astaghfirullah. Another person came and told him that no rain coming down. Show me something. He told him, Astaghfirullah, say Astaghfirullah. Then one person was beside of Hassan al-Basri. He told him, why you answer the same answer to the three people? He told, didn't you hear that? Saying the words of Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala, فَقُلْتُ اسْتَغْفِرُوا رَبَّكُمْ إِنَّهُ كَانَ غَفَّارًا. And he read all the ayah. In the same ayah, Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala says, وَيُمْدِدْكُمْ بِأَمْوَالٍ. If you want to grow, you want your business to grow up, you earn a lot of money. If you want Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala put barakah in your wealth, what you do? Say istighfar. Say astaghfirullah. Say astaghfirullah a lot of the times. Not only once and twice. I will mention in the end, inshallah, tabaraka wa ta'ala. Wabaneen. If you don't have children, if you don't have children, or you have daughters, no sons, or you have sons, no daughters, what you ask, oh, you don't have children at all, ask Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala forgiveness. Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala will give you children, inshallah, tabaraka wa ta'ala. One of the ulama mashayikh, he's saying that I gave a lecture about the istighfar, and afterwards, one person came to me, and he told me, Shaykh, I want to speak with you 1 minute, if you have 1 minute. He told him, okay. Then that person told a story to him that I didn't have a children for a long time. Then when I heard about the istighfar, me and my wife carry on the istighfar every day. Every day, every day, every day, we are saying istighfar. End of the month, wife gave me congratulations that there is a child from Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. Subhanallah. End of the year, Allah ta'ala gave me a son. I named him Yusuf. Second year, we were saying istighfar again. Second year again, Allah ta'ala gave him second son. The third year, Allah ta'ala gave him the third son. Then that person says, Sheikh says, this person told me that my wife, the third year, my wife told me that we will say istighfar inshallah ta'ala generally, but not only for the children. We will stop for a little while. Istighfar, we say istighfar for others inshallah ta'ala, not for children only. Inshallah tabaraka ta'ala. See, this is the mercy of Allah tabaraka ta'ala. This is the mercy of Allah. Say astaghfirullah, Allah ta'ala give you children. Allah ta'ala is so merciful. And also, if you want gardens, if you want a lot of pure water, what you do? Ask Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. وَيَجْعَلْ لَكُمْ جَنَّاتٍ وَيَجْعَلْ لَكُمْ أَنْهَارًا. This is from Allah. This is guarantee from who? From Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. And also, Imam Ahmad rahimahullah, I'll tell you his story. He told one day, I went to one masjid and I wanted to sleep in that masjid. The people told me, no, go out, go out. That was, he been to somewhere else. The people didn't know him. Then he told, okay, I come out from the masjid, and outside the masjid there was a place to put the shoes there. I told to the person, I will sleep tonight here, just here. I don't want inside, okay, as long as you don't let me, I will sleep here. Let me here, you know. You have to go out from here as well. Then that person, he started to dragging him. He was dragging Imam Ahmad. In that time, there was a person who was walking away, and he was bread maker. He was cooking bread. And he told him, okay, what is the problem? This is a problem. Okay, he told him, okay, stay tonight with me. Come with me. In the night, Imam Ahmad, rahimahullah, he is praying. And most of the night, he heard that person says, astaghfirullah, astaghfirullah, astaghfirullah. In the morning, after the prayer, Imam Ahmad, rahimahullah, he asked him, you are saying istighfar so much, so many times. Have you got anything, any good of it in this dunya? That person, he asked him, subhanallah, I got whatever I asked Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. I got everything which I asked from Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. But except one thing I haven't got it. What is that? I asked Allah ta'ala to see Imam Ahmad ibn Hanbal. I asked Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala a lot of time to see Imam Ahmad ibn Hanbal. Then Imam Ahmad told him, that is me, Imam Ahmad in front of you. Subhanallah. That is the virtue of the istighfar. Finally, inshallah, tabaraka ta'ala, there are few places, few times that we have to make istighfar, which Allah tabaraka ta'ala most will accept it from you. After the prayers, compulsory prayers. When you pray, then say astaghfirullah at least 3 times. Astaghfirullah, astaghfirullah, astaghfirullah. Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when he was leading prayer, before he turns his face to the musallis, he was saying, Astaghfirullah, Astaghfirullah, Astaghfirullah. Allahumma anta as-salamu minka as-salam, tabarakta ya dhal jalali wal ikram. Then he was turning his face to the musallis. Also, istighfar in Arafat, Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala said, فَإِذَا أَفَضْتُمْ مِنْ عَرَفَاتٍ فَاذْكُرُ اللَّهَ عِنْدَ الْمَشْعَرِ الْحَرَامِ. When you're coming coming down from the Arafat to Muzdalifa, ask Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. Ask Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala forgiveness. That is a place as well. And also, when a person, he gets elder, he have to make istighfar a lot in a lot. Why? Because the surah of An-Nasr revealed upon Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was 63 years of his age. Then the Sahaba, they understood that Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam gonna die. Of course, Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam died afterwards. In that surah, Allah ta'ala ordered to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and that order is to us as a nation, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, to us as well. إِذَا جَاءَ نَصْرُ اللَّهِ وَالْفَتْحِ وَرَأَيْتَ النَّاسَ يَدْخُلُونَ فِي دِينِ اللَّهِ أَفْوَاجًا فَسَبِّحْ بِحَمْدِ رَبِّكَ وَاسْتَغْفِرْهُ إِنَّهُ كَانَ تَوَّابًا. Allah Ta'ala ordered him, and this is an order for us, especially for our elders as well. And for the sisters, Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, once he gave khutbah of the Eid. Afterwards, he went and gave advice to the ladies. And he told them, O ladies, ask forgiveness from Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala as much as you can. Then one lady, she stood up and told, Ya Rasulullah, why? What is that? Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he told her that there is nothing in your mentality and also nothing in your deen as well. Therefore, for the sisters, because of those things they have, and they will have it till day of judgment, ask Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala forgiveness. This is the advice of who? Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And what are the words which we ask Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala istighfar with it? You can say astaghfirullah. You can say astaghfirullah alladhi la ilaha illa hu wa atubu ilayh. And also there is a sayyidul istighfar. Allahumma anta rabbi la ilaha illa anta khalaqtani. وأنا عبدك وأنا على عهدك ووعدك ما استطعت أعوذ بك من شر ما صنعت وأبوء بنعمتك علي وأبوء بذنبي فإنه لا يغفر الذنوب إلا أنت. This is the dua of Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to say this dua. What is the virtue of this dua? Afterwards, after I mentioned the meaning of this dua, I will tell it to you. O Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, anta rabbi, you are my Lord. La ilaha illa ant, there is no really God except you. Anta khalaqtani, O Allah ta'ala, you created me. Wa ana abduk, and I am your slave. Wa ana ala ahdika wa wa'dika mastata'at. Whatever I promised you, I couldn't do it, ya Allah tabarak wa ta'ala. A'udhu bika min sharri ma sana'at. I seek refuge from the bad what I have done, O Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. Wa abu'u laka bi ni'matika alayya. And I am saying about the ni'mats which you gave it to me. You gave me a lot of ni'mats, O Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. Wa abu'u bi dhanbi, O Allah ta'ala, I am saying that I am muznib. I have a lot of sin. I have done a lot of sin. Faghfir li, O Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala, forgive me. فَإِنَّهُ لَا يَغْفِرُ الذُّنُوبَ إِلَّا أَنْتِ. Indeed, no one can forgive anyone except you, Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala. What a beautiful words. This is the words which exactly pronounced Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, pronounced these words. And what is the virtues of these words? Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he says, if a person, he read it in the morning with the complete faith, aqidah in his heart, complete aqidah in his heart, till sunset, if he dies, he will enter to the Jannah. And he will be one of Ahl al-Jannah, inshaAllah. Tabarak wa ta'ala. And if he or she read it in night, before sunrise, he or she dies, Allah tabarak wa ta'ala make them from the Ahl al-Jannah, inshaAllah. Tabarak wa ta'ala. Finally, the time is almost over. And Sheikh Anwar told, you have to give us 40 minutes. There is no 40 minutes. That's it. Okay.
20 minutes.
20 minutes? Okay, inshallah. All right. The final thing is, like Imam Ibn Qayyim, rahmatullahi alayhi, he mentioned as well, that if you make istighfar from Allah tabaraka ta'ala, you have to, don't do any mistake. You don't have to, you have to stop from that sin. It does not mean that you're making sin in the same time you make istighfar. That is not gonna work. Imam Fudayl ibn Iyad, he says, if a person, he make istighfar that way, he make a sin. He have to make istighfar from that, for that as well, again. For example, a person says, astaghfirullah, then he carry on with the sin, he making sin. Saying astaghfirullah, that is ibadah, to say astaghfirullah. But he turn it to that sin. Why? Because he carry on with his sin. And he says he have to say astaghfirullah for that sin he had made it. For that astaghfirullah he had made it the first time. Therefore, my dear brothers in Islam, when we make astaghfirullah, it means we have to know the shurut at tawbah, the condition of repentance, which are five, we mentioned a few times. We have to carry on with that. Finally, inshallah ta'ala, ask Allah tabaraka ta'ala to make us from those who are pious, to make us from those who are learning Quran and Sunnah of Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and acting upon it and passing to others. وَمَا عَلَيَّ إِلَّا الْبَلَاغُ الْمُبِينَ. جَزَاكُمُ اللَّهُ خَيْرًا وَحَيَّاكُمُ اللَّهُ.